first, an 11 News I-Team update.
Bail was set at $50,000 cash each for two men accused of running a Baltimore County pill mill. 11 News I-Team reporter Deborah Wiener has been investigating this operation for months now and joins us live in the newsroom with the latest. Deborah.
Well, Donna, the state made it very clear in open court today of this pair. The prosecutors saying they facilitated the abuse and distribution of oxycodone to the tune of millions of dollars in a clinic where medical exams and real treatment for pain were non-existent, says the state. And doctors were hired to do one thing: write prescriptions for addictive narcotics.
The state paints 79-year-old Gerald Weisberg from Boca Raton as a seasoned pill mill financier who headed up a multi-million-dollar cash business out of the Beltway Professional Building on York Road and was arrested at the airport on Tuesday.
We're not going to talk about the case. I don't think it's a good idea, but in the trial, all the cases and all the facts will be presented.
The state says Russian immigrant Michael Reznikov oversaw day-to-day operations at the clinic that said it treated everything from back pain to migraines.
Can we talk to you about the pain clinic?
As the I-Team learned in the past several months, it quickly became known across the country as a place to get oxycodone prescriptions with little questions asked and cash up front.
When you get on this medicine here, it's highly addictive, then it'll definitely make you come after it.
Prosecutors revealed today the alleged pill mill brought in $36,000 a day as up to 80 so-called patients came in for so-called treatment. More arrests are likely in this case, and Weisberg's attorney wants to know if the state is going to seek out the doctors who wrote the prescriptions for a salary of $1,200 a day before this clinic was shut down.
And that is one of the questions remaining. Now, two doctors have already been suspended by the Board of Physicians, but as far as criminal charges, that has not occurred. There's also scrutiny of an MRI center that appeared to work in tandem with the pain clinic. This is a very active investigation that will surely take many turns. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Deborah Wiener.
Deborah, thank you. New tonight.